Civil fines are one thing, though. To actually bring, criminal case, don't you have to prove intent?
Absolutely.
And can you prove intent on Goldman Sachs?
It gets
intent to defraud.
It gets harder to prove this, and this is where the complexity and structure of an organization creates insulation as you move up the hierarchy, because proving the intent to deceive as the paper trail gets a little thinner is a problem. But the civil charges that should be brought are there, screaming out to be brought based on the Levin report, based upon the other documents that are out there. And the fact that it hasn't been done yet is really staggering.
Do you think politicians are scared of going against Goldman
Sachs? Absolutely. I mean, Goldman Sachs was the number one private campaign contributor to Barack Obama's presidential election campaign. It's one of the single biggest campaign contributors to both parties in Congress. So it's a rare event when, an establishment politician like Carl Levin decides to open up a shooting war against a company like this. It just doesn't happen very much because the consequences for these politicians are so severe. And that's one of the reasons why they've lasted
Anderson,
this long.
Before I went after Merrill Lynch, which is the first case we filed many years back, I was told by their lawyer, and this is a direct quote, "Be careful, we have powerful friends."
Do you think the Justice Department will prosecute?
If they don't, shame on them. If they don't, the Attorney General should resign if he can't bring this case.
Really?
Yes. I am.
You think it's an easy
Anderson,
case?
It is so outrageous to me. The deeper we dig and the more fundamental the violations we see, that these investment banks hiding behind the patina that they would take care of the public interest in regulating the stock market, time and time again, scammed, deceived, and our tax dollars are paying those grotesque bonuses that we still read about.
I remember there was a quote in one of the articles you wrote, Matt, and I don't want to quote it word for word because it was quite, descriptive, but it was somebody saying that basically if one of these guys was sent to prison, that would stop these shenanigans from happening again. That's really all it would take. If somebody was held accountable, it would have a cooling effect.
Yeah, absolutely. I talked to one guy who was a former SEC investigator, and he said basically, if you start sending Lloyd Blankfein or one of those guys, put him in one of those guys in a real maximum security prison for 6 months, this whole thing would be over very quickly. The whole situation would be cleared up. But the problem is, there's no incentive for these guys to change their behaviors because they never ever get punished. Not only do they not get punished, they get a bailout.
Has there been any change in regulation? I mean, is the regulation better now? Is the oversight better?
Look, Dodd-Frank made some improvements, and it was better to have it than not have it. But it doesn't change the simple fact that all you need is common law fraud on the books or there as a theory. A prosecutor who wants to go after Wall Street banks for lying will do it. That hasn't happened yet. It should happen. Matt